The Gatimamri Lawmayor says 2015 will be a busy year for the council, just like the previous year, and he wants the $8.5 million estimated revenue from the sale of land to be collected by the end of June this year. He called upon his colleagues to ensure that in the next council management meeting, huge amounts of land allocation for both business and residential purposes are effected. The mayor further called on the management of the town council and the staff to be commanders of themselves in ensuring that the residents of the town are saved without fail.
And I'm going to say that I'm saddened by the issue of water interruption three times. Someone just fails to go and buy units, and the whole town is punished for that. And he claims he wants to get a salary. For what? That sabotage won't be tolerated this year. It's a simple issue we walk to, even in our houses. If there's no, I make it a point every day in my house. Before I go to work, I check how much are my units for electricity. My wife tells me, my chair, I'm kawure. That's a pattern we got it in our house. But at council, 20,000 people, someone just sitting in office, gossiping, doing nothing. 12 o'clock, there's no water. You ask units to pay, that will never be allowed.
He acknowledged the challenge with unserviced land, but said there is need to engage local development partners and the council clients who have been given land for upfront payment to service land. The mayor stressed that residents are in need of housing, sanitation, roads and jobs amongst others, saying such challenges need to be overcome through hard work and determination. Matengu also encouraged residents of Katimamlilo to ensure that they attend council meetings in order to contribute to the development of the town and not to be misled by individuals. Sililo Muviana, NBC News, Katimamlilo.